So Ewan, how was that? You're just playing Terminal V. What is it like playing to a Scottish crowd?
So like when I come to Edinburgh, like it's the other side of the country where I'm from in here. And like the reception's just mental. It's the best feeling ever. And Scottish crowds are the best in the world.
Your track, Tell Me Something Good, got to number 15 in the UK Top 40 last year.
Mental, man.
So did you ever think that would happen when you made that tune?
Nah, because I've not listened to chart music for about 8 years. Like, I don't listen to the top 40. When Tell Me Something Good did it, like, I appreciated it so much, man. It was so cool that it went into the charts, but folk asked me, like, oh, what are you going to do next? And I'm like, just keep making music that I love, because that's what I'm doing it for. I'm not going to do it to make music for other people. I do it for myself, and I think I'd be in it for the wrong reasons if I didn't, like.
And how much has life changed for you since you've blown up?
Massively, man. I've got money for the first time in 8 years. Everyone says to me, oh, you must be making loads of money. And I'm like, mate, I went 8 years with no money, like, to get to this point. Do you know what I mean? It's not like I'm rich or whatever. I've just got money for the first time in my life. Whereas, like, I used to scrounge. Like, I could barely afford food sometimes when I was just doing music. And, like, folk only see, like, the success. Do you know what I mean? Like, I used to take my aux cord and plug it into my laptop and go down the beach in my car, air beach in my car, and make music through my car speakers because I couldn't afford... Like, do you know what I mean? Like, and that's, like, the stuff you need to go through, I think, to prepare you. Obviously, I've had a break now and it's amazing, but I think I'm so well prepared for it now. Like, that feeling of accomplishment after working so hard for so many years, that it's the best feeling in the world. So, yeah, it's changed massively. So much, man. It's crazy.
So if I'd said to you 5 years ago that you're going to be where you are right now, what would you have said? What would you have thought?
Oh, I'd done exactly what I just done there. I would just laughed at you, honestly. Like, I don't know, like, I never thought I'd even have fans, you know. Like, that's crazy to me, like, that folk are, like, that inspired by me. And, like, I don't think of myself as anything special. We're all equal, we're all people. But the fact that I can, like, mate, I take, like, 10 seconds out of my night and take a selfie with somebody and they go mental. Or, like, there's folk, like, I've took a selfie with them and they're shaking and I'm like, chill out, man, I'm just a normal person, do you know what I mean?
And have you had any requests for collabs from big artists that you're allowed to talk about?
Elton John actually asked me to do a remix, but it wasn't right for me at the time, so I just kind of, yeah. But yeah, like, how crazy is that? I'm like just a wee guy for air, and Elton John's asked me to remix his tunes. It's crazy. Yeah. So I released on Diplo's label, so talked to him, talked to Calvin Harris. Like, it's so mad, man. Like, because I don't think of myself as this. Whoever thinks of me, whatever they think of me, I just think I'm just a wee guy for air that loves tunes.